Trainer Dogs, it's Stacy, and today I wanted to do a yoga video for you. This will be broken up into different sections, so there'll be a warm-up and just different parts. It's yoga for inflexible people. So there's a warm-up, there's getting kind of our back warmed up, there's a couple of standing poses, and it's just a very playful, wiggly kind of routine. So that you can really get deep and stretch into those muscles. A lot of times in a traditional yoga practice, we might be in a pose for 30 seconds, and I find that for me, that's just not long enough to really see any benefits as far as flexibility goes. Sure, I might get warm, and the class might feel good, and it might be fantastic to be there, but I find that I've always been an inflexible person. I could never do a split when I was even 7 years old when we're at our most flexible. And now as I'm getting older, I want to keep as much flexibility as I possibly can. And I find that this routine and this style happens to work for me. So I hope it works for you too. Like I said, it will be broken down into several different parts. And when I post it, it should be so that you could, if you got them all in order, you should be able to watch the next one and the next one and the next one, and I'll try to do a playlist so that you can do that, but you could also pick and choose what it is that you want to do. It will gradually warm you up, even though we're not doing traditional sun salutations, so I would suggest trying to do them in that order so that you do get warm before you get into some of the more deeper stretches. The things that you might need would be possibly a strap, okay, so make sure you've got one of those handy. Because I'm assuming that if you're watching this, you're probably not inflexible. So if you are a Gumby type person, I don't know why you would watch this video. If you're that person, you probably don't need a strap. But for us inflexible people, a strap, definitely. And then maybe a couple of blocks. You might need them, you might not, but it's always better to have them handy and not need them than the other way around. Okay, so we've got those. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is just get situated in a simple cross-legged position, and there's no legs stacked here. These are ankle in front of ankle. Hands are just gonna rest. We wanna pull our abdominals in to lift us up nice and tall. Close your eyes. I mean, if you wanna watch, you can, but I'll try to talk you through as best I can. A lot of times when our eyes are open, we tend to think about the movement as opposed to feeling it, and I really want you to be able to feel this. So we're going to close our eyes, we've got our abdominals in, we're lifting tall, we should feel like we've got beautiful posture, but we're not stiff and rigid. Fingers are loose, give them a little wiggle, check in with your shoulders, check your seat, you're sitting on your sits bones, you shouldn't be tilted back in your pelvis like this, to be able to kind of sit up nice and strong, you can wiggle and move things around if you need to, and just be able to hold that without being rigid. Your head just rests on top of your spine, and we're just going to breathe here. In and out through the nose, if you need to breathe through your mouth, if that's how you prefer to breathe, or you have a stuffed up nose, absolutely. The belly, when we inhale, expands, and when we exhale, it contracts, the breath moves up into the lungs. Check on your face, keep your face nice and loose also. I'll give you some guidance, but this is mainly kind of self-guided. So I'll put you in poses, but it's up to you to explore and notice how it feels in your body and what your body needs. Okay, so we're just gonna sway. So we wanna get any places that are already tight. It could be the back, shoulders, neck, might be your hips. We wanna get that start to release. One shoulder at a time go, you let the head move, you let the neck move, but you just sort of play with it. Where are you tight? You can take it down, you can take it low. And then from there, we're gonna circle from the navel down, just hip circles, just bring it around. So you feel that rib cage sliding over the rib cage. The rib cage sliding, sorry, over the pelvis. Again, fingers are loose, shoulders are loose. There's no stiffness here. We're trying to get everything. just below navel and below. And then turn it into a big circle. And as you go back right here, you might want to hold on to your knees so you can really get some distance there. And this might seem weird if you haven't taken yoga that's real wiggly like this. Let's reverse direction. I just ask that you try the whole thing through, so all the pieces together, and then just see how you feel at the end of it, if you feel looser. And if you do, it did its job. I don't think it has to be stiff, rigid yoga. I think we want to take care of our low backs and really pull our abdominals in and do things just a little differently, and I'll explain that as we go. So let's bring our chin into our chest and just let the head hang. Kind of give the arms a little movement, a little shake, a little wiggle. Notice if you're feeling any stretching at the base of the skull or between the shoulder blades down the neck. And we'll bring the chin towards the ceiling without crunching the back of the neck. Keep some space there. And back down. And it's up and down. Notice if you're gripping with your fingers, even though the hands are on your knees, just let them rest. Let your elbows dangle from your shoulders. And next circle, bring it around in one direction. I had a little crack there, and go the other way. And as you're doing that, just notice, as you're moving, do you feel pulling or tightness in any of these directions? And we're not trying to fix anything, we're just trying to be aware at this point. Some of us might feel like the Tin Man and the Wizard of Oz. We want someone to bring us our oil can. And then kind of give the shoulders some movement. Little tiny circles. You can make them as big as you want, like big up into the ears, and then keep them that high and press it back, 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 and you should get all of this. And then keep it back and press it down. And then bring it front. And you can play with that, but try that full range of motion. And then we're gonna bring our hands front and clasp them and then stretch them out. And we're not doing anything with the shoulders here. Just look at your hands, focus on your hands, and feel the fingers and the palms stretch. And then pull the belly and stretch there, and you can wiggle. So there's a lot of movement here. We don't really hold a pose super static in this style. It's really just playing. What does my body want me to do? And then we'll bring those hands around back and clasp them. And then just check when you're clasping. Sometimes we have a tendency to kind of break one wrist to one side. Really focus back there that your wrists are even, that you're not twisting to one side or the other. So nice and long. Let's inhale, lift up. Glue your sits bones down and just start to lean forward. And again, we can move and we can play. And just feel what's going on in the back. And then lift it up. And we're just gonna let our thumbs or our hands either touch the ground or get as close to the ground as possible. We're all built a little differently. And we'll hold and just open up the throat to the ceiling, open up the chest, maybe give those fingers a little wiggle. You're gripping, but you don't want to hang on for dear life or white knuckle anything. And then we'll just sort of, let's switch our legs so that we've got a different front one so that we never have one hip that's more open than the other. We always want to try and keep them as even as possible. And then from here, checking in, we're gonna grab our strap. You may or you may not need it for cow face pose. So we'll start with the strap on our left side. We're gonna take the left arm out to the side and we're gonna rotate the arm backwards. So an internal rotation, so the palm faces back, and we're just gonna bring the arm behind us and scoot it up your back. The right arm comes around and we're going to scooch and try to get either our hands to touch or maybe you're gripping onto your strap, okay? So once you've got a hold of whatever you get a hold of, you bring those hands closer and closer together. Still holding tall in our posture. We can wave and wiggle and move. We want this elbow to be nice and high on this right arm. We don't want to feel like it's kind of pushing us in. So try to keep it. So if that means your hands aren't touching, if your hands touch and that happens to you, maybe separate them just slightly so that you still have that good posture. And then you just continue to practice this series and try to notice the difference. Like if it would be ideal if you could practice it every day, but even if you practice it once a week, notice if you're starting to see a difference, if your hands get closer together, if you're not as stiff day to day. All right, we're gonna move this to the other side. Right arm comes out, internally rotate. We're gonna bring it around and under, bring it as high up as you can, get a little scoochy scooch there, and then bring the arm up, left arm up, and try to touch. The two sides rarely match, so maybe you could touch fingertips together before and now you can't. It doesn't matter, okay? Just deal with what you're dealing with. Be very careful if you had a shoulder injury. Same thing, we're just as tall as we can, but then we can wiggle and we can play and we can just see what we're feeling. Trying not to be rigid and stiff, so even as we hold a pose, we don't want it to turn into this stiffness and this rigidity. We want to try and stay loose. And release. Good, and we can set our strap to the side. We're going to take it to the side, our body side to side, so we're going to stretch through here. We'll keep our right hip anchored as we bring our left hand down. We're going to come up and over. Check that range of motion on that arm. See where it goes. Does it go behind? Does it go over? Does it go front? Just kind of play with that. Notice if you're feeling tightness anywhere. Let's go the other way. So keep, again, anchored. We don't want this hip to pop up. If it's down, we get more of a stretch through and lengthening through our side. And we're going to open. And breathing. Check in with it. Good. And then we're just going to take it side to side. Just sort of play with it. Feel maybe it goes in the hip. Maybe you come a little forward. Maybe you come a little back. Forward and back. Just sort of see what works for you. Maybe you swing it to the front. Take it forward. So hands, we're going to walk. My hands are out of frame, but trust me, they're still there. And lengthen down. And then just again, side to side. Keep the sits bones down. Lengthening through the spine. That should feel good. Letting the head drop if that works for you. I hope you can hear me. I don't have a microphone, but I'm trying to project. And just holding, and then walking it or rolling it up, and just take a moment to check in. And that's pretty much our warm-up. We're gonna have a second, like a Chakravrakasana next for our back. So join me for that one.